Hello, and welcome back to my series on learning commands in Minecraft. My name is slicedlime, and today we're going to learn what is perhaps one of the most central concepts in all of Minecraft commands, one that will unlock your ability to do things more than anything we've seen this far. That thing is the execution context and the execute command. Simply put, the execute command lets you run other commands, but lets you change how those commands are run. This far, we've run commands, we've put commands in command blocks and let them run commands, we've used relative coordinates to refer to positions around us, and we've used selectors to select entities based on arguments. Despite all these abilities, there are some seemingly simple things we can't do. We know how to select Pigo here, and we know the set block command, and we know how to refer to a relative coordinate one block below. So how do we change the block under Pigo to be a gold block? We can't. Relative coordinates in the set block refer to the place the command is being executed. If I run it, tilde, tilde negative 1, tilde is the block below me. If a command block runs it, the same position as the block below the command block. This is where the execute command comes in. It lets us change things about the execution context, which includes where the command is run. Now, like many other concepts in this series, the execute command is a very complex beast, and we'll be learning parts of it over several episodes. So don't worry if there are pieces of the syntax that you don't understand. The basic syntax is execute, followed by a number of modifiers, followed by run, and then another command. The first such modifier we're going to look at is at. One good thing about the execute command is that reading it out loud very often gives you a pretty good idea of what it does. Let's put that to the test. Execute at e type equals pig, tag equals pigo, run set block tilde tilde negative 1 tilde gold block. I'm sure you can guess what that does. We're running the command at the end, tilde tilde negative 1 tilde gold block. Set the block here, but down one block to a gold block. But execute that command at a different position, the one specified by the entity and the selector. That could even match more than one entity, in which case a copy of the command would run in the position of each one of them. Execute at e, run, set block, tilde, tilde negative 1, tilde, diamond block. That would set the block at the feet of every single entity in the world to a diamond block, one set block command at a time. Let's skip that one though, that'd mess a little too much with our world here. If you think back to the commands we've learned this far, you might remember a few cases where it also mattered who was running a command. The game mode command required an extra argument if it ran in a command block that wasn't necessary if you ran it from the chat input, for instance. The kill command killed me when I ran it, but obviously that wouldn't happen in a command block. Even the simple old say command acts differently. It says my name in chat when I run it, but an at sign if it gets run in a command block. In fact, the entity executing a command is also a part of the execution context. Notice how I said entity here, not player. We can make any entity be the one executing a command. Execute as, at e, type equals pig, tag equals pigo, run, say oink. Just like before, what it does seems relatively obvious. We execute the command as a different entity than ourselves, and the chat output confirms that Pigo has in fact learned to talk through the magic of commands. One thing to keep in mind here is that each modifier only changes one thing, so if we combine the two commands into execute as at e type equals pig, tag equals Pigo, run set block tilde tilde negative 1 tilde emerald block, that still sets an emerald block underneath my feet, not Pigo's, because while Pigo is now running the command, the position is still where it was to begin with, which is at my position. Pigo is changing the block under my feet. So what if we want to do both? Trying to combine the two is awkward. Execute as at e type equals pig, tag equals pigo at e type equals pig, tag equals pigo, run set block tilde tilde negative 1 tilde. Okay, that very quickly became rather long command. But it would have worked, right? Or would it? Well, kind of. But only because there's only one Pigo. If we had two entities, both the modifiers would find the two entities, which means we wouldn't run two commands, we'd run four. Each entity would run set block commands at two different locations. When we learned about entity selectors a few episodes ago, we left one for later, at S. This is where that one comes in. Just like you could think of at A as all, at P as player, and at E as entity, you can think of at S as self. @s always matches the entity running the command. You can still apply selector arguments to it to filter it further, but it will always match at most one entity, and that will always be the entity running the command. Say @s. We'll just say my own name. Execute as @etype=pig, tag=pigo, run say @s, says pig. Execute as @e_sort=nearest, limit=10, run say @s. This clearly shows us that execute can take the same command and run it multiple times, and that can have different outcomes depending on which entity is running the command. So plugging that into our command from before, we get execute as @e_tag=pig, tag=pigo, @s run setblock --(-1)--diamond block. This use of the execute command to change both who runs a command and where it runs is extremely common, and very powerful. Let's try another example. Let's say I want a superpower to freeze the world around me. I could run a fill command, like fill --(1)--(-1)--(-1)--(-1)--(-1) ice replace water. That replaces any water blocks below my feet with ice in a 3x3 sheet, much like the Frostwalker enchantment. Not much of a superpower when you have to stop every step to run a command though. So of course we'd really like to stick that command into a repeating command block. Of course, just pasting the same thing in would make it apply to the blocks below the command block, so we need the execute command here. Let's say we're feeling generous. Let's give the superpower to all players. Execute as @s run fill --(1)--(-1)--(-1)--(-1)--(-1)--(-1) ice replace water. Let's set that block to always active and have a stroll on the lake. Awesome! If you are also being given the superpower of Minecraft commands by this video, please execute a click on the like button to give this video the superpower of YouTube algorithm success. Thanks, I appreciate that. One thing to keep in mind is that everything changes position, not just blocks and such. That also includes any selectors we run and the argument. So if I was to select something using a distance argument or sort by nearest, those would check against the new position, not the old one. Another case where changing the execution context is very useful is with the teleport command. Let's make a silly contraption here that makes any chickens I approach teleport to above my head. We can do that by combining many of these concepts. This time, I want this, superpower to only activate on players that have a certain tag. Let's call it chicken prank. Let's start with an execute command. Execute as @a tag=chicken prank. @s run. TP @e type=chicken. distance=between 4 and 5. --(3)-. So all players tagged chicken prank are going to execute a command at their own position, and that command is a teleport command to teleport any chicken that is between 4 and 5 blocks away to be 3 blocks above their own feet. Let's turn that on and have a walk around. And obviously, to make anything happen, I need to also apply that tag to myself. We do that using the tag command we learned last time. Tag @s add chicken prank. Using @s in this way is a simple shortcut to not having to write out your own nickname in command. And now, I have chickens popping up over my head. It's just a prank, bro. There's lots more to learn about the execute command, but we're going to leave it at that for this time. It is well worth taking time to really get used to using execute, so please get the companion map and play through the exercises there. If you run into any problems, feel free to join my Discord server where we have a channel for learning commands. My name is slicedlime. Thank you for learning commands with me.